Congress. But there's another piece to this, as I was thinking and reading my statement, I said 30 years, that's a long time. But we have to preserve this history. We really do. People keep telling me to write my book, and I'm going to write, I just keep procrastinating. But we have to write the history, or it's like it never happened. And if we don't put that history out there, how are you going to have the people that come after me who, you know, who didn't get, at least I was 30-something when Reverend Lewis did this. But, I mean, kids coming up now, they may not see enough of this. And so I beg you to keep pushing his life and what he stood for. And that he was, you know, an ordinary man called to an extraordinary mission. And in the process of doing the extraordinary, he became extraordinary. And I really believe that. And you never know the influence that a person, even from a distance, can have on you. But I know that in my DNA, there's a Reginald Lewis all in my DNA. And so I am very, very, it makes me proud, very proud to celebrate with you. Right? So y'all got me crying a bit. You know what I mean?
You make me cry.
No, but I really appreciate that. Because, I mean, a lot of times we don't, you know, fully understand a lot of times what black men and black women, but particularly black men,
have gone through.
Go through. You know, and I'm sure he had a lot of haters. Come on now. I know he had, but I'm sure he had a lot of haters. He had a lot of people saying, telling him he couldn't do it. There were a lot of people saying that he was crazy. I'm sure, you know, how dare you do this? And then there are a lot of people who probably tried to discount what he did. See, that's the other piece. Discount, find holes in, oh, he didn't really do that. So-and-so did that. He didn't do that. And that's why we have to lift us up. So I thank you all so very much for taking up the time to be here, to celebrate that life, to celebrate the accomplishments. You know, and a lot of times I say to people, it's not the deed, it's the memory. It's not what he did, it's the memory of what he did, of what he stood for. And you know what? There's a, you know, one of my favorite plays is The Lion King. I love The Lion King. I mean, I love it so much. I've seen it probably 17 times. I love it. Let me tell you why. I love it for a lot of reasons, but there's a portion of the line where the young cub loses his father. And he, one day he said, oh, and after his father dies, he says, Father, where are you? If I could only touch you, if I could only hear your voice for a moment, please let me just hear your voice. I just want to hear it. And then she keeps saying, where are you? Where are you? And then that's track 16. On track 17, they answer the question. And that is, it says, he lives in you. He lives in you. And that's what it's all about. And we, you know, we want to keep this great legacy going. We've got to let the things that he stood for, the things that he believed in, live in us. And I'm so glad that I'm the beneficiary of that. And I've often said that our children are the living messages we send to a future we will never see. And I'm glad to be one of the children that Reginald Lewis touched so that I can send his message on to another generation. And so, again, thank you so very much.
Thank you.
You all have thanked me, and I thank you. All right.
Okay. Excuse me.